Good evening, and welcome to Live from the Dome. My name is Nick Duart with Fort Collins Museum of Discovery. Thank you for tuning into our monthly live stream music series. Throughout the pandemic, we were unable to host live events, but thanks to the generosity of Bohemian Foundation and their Muse Grant program, we've been able to bring these virtual concerts directly to you while supporting local musicians who have been unable to perform. Tonight's performance is by the Fort Collins-based duo of identical twin sisters, Sophia and Jo Babb. The pair's music presents immaculate harmonies, delicate folk melodies, and a nuanced approach to songwriting that feels at once lighthearted and weighted with palpable empathy. Music from their upcoming debut explores themes of new growth, healing, and the natural beauty surrounding us. It arrives as a comfort to anyone in need of a warm embrace and a reminder to find wonder in the small things. It's my pleasure to welcome to the Dome stage, Companion.
When we first met, I was struck, I was new. You felt what did not exist. You fed me and I grew. So how can I have
We're Companion. I'm Sophia.
I'm Jo.
And this is our first time ever step foot in this museum. We've never been here, ever. It's exciting, fantastic. I was on the way to the bathroom earlier. I had to pass by some beautiful little rodents and pictures of bobcats, and super cool. So that's kind of the vibe we want to bring today, is bobcats and rodents.
The entrance to this dome has a lot of space stuff around it, and it kind of triggered an existential crisis because I just discovered the solar flare things that are happening.
I don't even want to know. Don't tell
it's
me.
It's bad. Well, it's not that bad. It actually happens all the time.
Sounds like a compliment. It's like, you got solar flare. So, yeah.
I would take that if someone said that to me. But, yeah, anyways. Hopefully it doesn't interrupt this live stream.
Yeah, hope not. This next one is called Snowbank.
I wrote this a few snowy Februarys ago.
something like them. Nested in your covers, might as well have been a snowbank. In my fingers beat a heartache I've never known. Oh, what are you doing? Letting me touch you like that.
I loved how it was the longest intro ever.
I start when I feel right, you know?
Yeah.
And then we gotta make that eye contact.
We haven't been playing shows together recently very often because of COVID, obviously, and the twin telepathy just hasn't been.
It's been a little lousy.
It's been a little off course. We had to do a twin retreat or something. We're like curl up really close next to each other, like we're in the womb.
Yeah, sometimes to reset, we have to do that.
Like, we have to charge our twin power. This next one's called 23rd Street. We moved from Oklahoma City to Fort Collins, Colorado I moved in 2019 and Joe moved in 2020. So
right at the beginning of 2020. And boy, did I have a year in store for me.
We had just graduated college and it was our first time leaving home. And it's just such a big time of change. So we wrote this song during that time. We actually just released this song as a single just a couple weeks ago, so it's on Spotify if you want to listen to it.
And you can see 23rd Street in the video that it comes with, because it's where we filmed it on Christmas night.
Yep. The music video gives you a grand tour.
Pick up the wind, take up my words and let it set me down again. I don't know how or if someone now is listening. There was something different then, well, I know it now. To be young and to know it, is something found. A subtle difference then. And raced on to a dead end, across mountain trails and river beds, through broken men. We pick up the wind, take up my words and let it set us down again. I don't know how always someone now is listening. There was something different then. Subtle difference then is so big now. It's
This next one is called Arm's Length. Joe and I grew up in a really large family. We're at the tail end of 12 kids. And thank God my mom didn't give birth to all of them. That would be, I think, quite insane.
Thank God for her, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah.
Her body.
Yeah. But living in a big family, there's a lot of opportunity for strange relationship dynamics and family dynamics. And, you know, I know plenty of tiny families that have the most insane family drama, so just imagine that times 12, and that's what you get. And our family's a wonderful, beautiful patchwork of people, but lots of different personalities. So the song is about navigating those relationships and trying to figure out if family is really, you know, who's your blood, or if it's just the people that care for you.
It's now time for our title track of our upcoming record, Second Day of Spring.
Unfortunately, it's not releasing on the Second Day of Spring.
That's
that already passed. It's going to be released May 27th. And it's been a long time coming. We recorded the album with Courtney Hartman, one of our favorite artists. She produced it and engineered it in her tiny barn in 2020. So it's been 2 years since recording these songs, and even longer since writing them. So we're so ready to have it out.
This is one of our oldest songs, actually.
Yeah. This was written when Joe was a heartbreaker.
Yeah, I wrote it when I knew I had to really let someone down, and that's a really hard thing to do. One second.
Thank you.
second day of spring, another season behind me. I don't feel any different, though there's someone new beside me. And the sun kisses my skin, ever gently, ever burning. And I can't shake the wanting that, ever yearning that I've left alone too long. Shaking me inside out, I know where I do and don't belong, but right here, it's all right here. So I guess I can't stay a while.
This next one's a song I wrote for a person who's very special to me. We met at the beginning of the pandemic, or right before, actually, at a song swap. And then the pandemic happened, and it just so happened that he was my neighbor down the street. So he was one of my only friends that lived nearby, and we would just meet up and go on walks all through March and April and May. And this is for him. It's called Forfeit. Thank you.
to trust I'm after. It's you knowing that I'd never let you feel ashamed. And you can say
So having a bad breakup is bad enough, but then having your ex, be a frequenter of every place you frequent in your small town in Oklahoma is even worse. I wrote this song when I felt like I just could not escape really awkward and anxiety-inducing situations.
Yeah, it's like he moved to Colorado and he still manages to be in town.
So it happens when you date a person who goes on tour with touring bands.
Yeah.
This is called Lingering.
Catches my gaze. They see me, see your man. They start to wait. That's when I saw you against the background. Me and my friend, we get to talking, or at least won't you stop playing?
We've gotten through the set really fast. We only just have a couple more. If you want to throw in any new ones, feel for it, Joe. This next song is called If I Were a Ghost. Song's about loss and grieving. We have had our fair share of grief in our lifetimes, in our short lifetimes so far. We lost a lot of close people to us at early ages, pretty much starting when we were around 13. And we're no stranger to it. So this is one of the songs that we still play. All of our songs used to be about terribly sad things. Still have our fair share of sad songs, but this is our song that remains in our set over across the years about grief. It's okay.
Goodbye. Saying
Thank you so much. We just have one more, unless Joe wants to throw in. You know, the thing about playing new songs is that they're best played in audiences that are forgiving. And what more forgiving of an audience than a live stream audience? They can't throw tomatoes at you. They're powerless.
I'm just running through the lyrics in my head. I'm almost there. I think I can play it. I think I'll play Wonder.
Let's do it, yeah, sure.
I don't want to know the bridge.
Okay, well, we don't have to. I can also throw in one of mine, too. It's up to you. Good with that? Cool?
Yeah, I guess so.
Okay, cool.
Let's see if I remember it.
Time is not a straight line, it's a labyrinth. And if you get close at the right time, it will happen. When you hear yourself on the other side, ear person.
That new one.
I haven't played it live before, so thank you.
This is your second time.
I guess, well, that was like an open mic and I messed up, so that was great to get to play that here.
Thanks for
I remembered my
being
words
a guinea pig
in the middle of yours, so
might as well.
New song it. Showdown.
It's relatively new. It's more new as in it hasn't been played live very many times at all.
Yeah. Well, that's vulnerability right there. Thank you to everyone who's listening out there. I wish I could see you.
He's busy. This is called A Wonder. Walk run snow cold, do our thing alone. Bright sun kiss laugh, there is nowhere left to go. There's nothing left to know. No fear, small doubt, sister in a warm house. Quiet I am, watching you talk about what you love. There's nothing left undreamed of. Close kiss, closed fist, mostly sleepless. We'll never get rest, tangled up like this. Looking at each other feels like knowing one another. And understanding, a wonder.
Comment capabilities on YouTube, so you have to vote in the comments whose new song was better.
I think Sophie's is better, honestly.
I vote for you.
That's just a micro song, you know?
Yeah. Doesn't count. This is our last song. It's called To Be Still. Thank you so much for tuning in, and thanks to the crew for putting this on. It feels like we're in space, and I'll definitely be coming back.
You know, we are in space.
That is true.
At all times. All the time. The sun can get you.
The solar flares.
It's like funny, we go about our lives and we're like roads and sidewalks and bicycles and cars and stuff. And then like that's just, you know, and then there's the sun out there and it can just like send magnetic frequencies our way. And that scares the shit out of me. And I don't know what's better, like being aware and like, I am at peace with our small role in the cosmos, or being completely oblivious.
I think it's better to not be aware. I think you'd be less neurotic.
We need to stop teaching about space in school. We're making everyone anxious. And by everyone, I mean me.
I do remember my astronomy class was quite the roller coaster. Again, we're Companion, and our new record, Second Day of Spring, is coming out on May 27th, and we have a couple of singles out, How Could I Have Known, and then 23rd Street out on Spotify, and our next single, Snowbank, is coming up just next week, so look out for that. Maybe I'm not good though. What's in this? I've been tuning all day. Okay, we're gonna call it good. Light your candles and
There's a different story. You could always tell yourself. Our small bodies are part of a bigger whole. So
thank you so much.